بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. أما بعد، حبيت في الله، it's important from any for anyone, any Muslim, to know whether they're from Ahl Sunnah or not, to know and understand Tawheed. And as Sheikh Muhammad mentioned, he said, إِنْهُ يَعْجِبُ عَلَيْنَا تَعَلَّمْ أَرْبَعَ مَسَائِلَ الْأُولَى الْعِلْمِ وَهُوَ مَعْرُوفَةَ اللَّهُ وَمَعْرُوفَةَ النَّبِيِّ وَمَعْرُوفَةَ الدِّينُ الْإِسْلَامِ بِيَدِ اللَّهِ. He mentioned, this great alim Rabbani, he mentioned that it's an obligation upon us to know four things, and we're just going to mention the first. He said, أَلْأُولَى الْعِلْمِ, the first thing is knowledge, and it is knowing Allah, and meaning knowledge is knowing Allah and knowing His Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and knowing the religion of Islam with textual proofs. Understand those three principles. Ahabati fillah, with regards to knowing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and this is what I wanted us to discuss today, so that we have an understanding, very concise, very quick, about tawheed and shirk. Tawheed, it is worshipping Allah alone without ascribing any partners to Him. So the ulama of this time, the Salafi scholars, and they have categorized Tawheed into three categories. Learn these three categories. That doesn't mean they invented this, but that means for our understanding and simplification that all of these categories of Tawheed were known to the Salaf, but they didn't codify them in the same way, because they understood Tawheed in a different manner, or they understood Tawheed without those categories. But they discussed, like Imam Abu Hanifa discussed Rububiyyah and discussed Uluhiyyah. And then the later scholars, they talked about Tawheed Al-Asma'i wa Sifat. And this is why some of the early books of Tawheed discussed Al-Asma'i wa Sifat, because they were refuting Ahl Bid'ah. But let's get back on track. Ahabati fillah, those three categories are, first, Tawheed Rububiyyah, meaning that that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the Lord of everything, and He's the creator of everything, and He's the sustainer of everything. Everything needs Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's Tawheed al-Rububiyyah. Tawheed al-Uluhiyyah, this is to single out Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone in worship, meaning you pray to Allah, you make hajj for Allah, you fast for Allah, you give sadaqah and charity for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you pay the zakat for Allah, for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You do all of those acts of worship, inward and outward, to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because those are actions of worship to who? To Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, سبحانه وتعالى قال ولقد بعثنا في كل أمة رسولا أن نعبد الله واجتنب الطاغوت. That we sent to every nation a message or a messenger to worship Allah alone and avoid those things worshipped besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Letting us know that what all the prophets alayhim afdal salatu wasalam were sent to their nations to call the people to worship Allah alone, to worship Allah alone, and that is an act. That means that requires action. In ni'budullah wajtanibu tagut, and avoid those things worship besides Allah. The third category, ahabati fillah, of tawheed is tawheed al-asma'i wa sifat, meaning that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has divine names and attributes. Allah is Ar-Rahman, Allah is Ar-Rahim, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Al-Khaliq, Al-Bari, Al-Musawwir, and He has divine names and attributes, so that those divine names and attributes are reserved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, that we cannot ascribe those attributes to His creation. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says fi kitab al-kareem, He subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the ayat, لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٌ وَهُوَ سَمْعِيُ الْبَصِيرُ, that there is nothing which is like unto Him or resembles Him, and He is the all-seeing, all-hearing, meaning that Allah hears and sees everything. That's a divine, those are divine attributes, because I can see, I can hear, but my hearing and seeing is limited. You can hear the people in the background who think I'm a strange person talking to myself, who don't understand my language. But however, that they, at the same time, their hearing and seeing is limited, and my hearing and seeing is limited, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala hears everything and sees everything subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that means we are not like Allah, and Allah is not like us. His attributes are divine and sacred and perfect, and we are imperfect. So those are the three categories of tawheed. As far as shirk, ahabati fillah, Shirk is to ascribe a partner to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to worship along with Allah, someone or something, or to worship someone or something besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As the Buddhists, they worship Buddha. As we know the other faiths, that they worship other than Allah. Some they worship the prophets, some they worship the grass and the trees, some they worship the sun and the moon. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, fi kitab al-kareem, وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ اللَّيْلِ وَالنَّهَارِ وَالشَّمْسِ وَالْقَمَرِ لَا تَشْرُوا لِلشَّمْسِ وَلَا لِلْقَمَرِ وَشِرُوا لِلَّهِ الَّذِي خَلَقَهُنَّ إِن كُنْتُمْ إِيَّاهُ تَعْبُدُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, في كتاب الكريم, and from his signs is the day and the night, and the sun and the moon, and the وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ اللَّيْلِ وَالنَّهَارِ وَالشَّمْسِ وَالْقَمَرِ لا تسجدوا للشمس ولا للقمر. Do not prostrate to the sun and do not prostrate to the moon, but prostrate to Allah, the one who created them, if it is him you truly worship. So that lets us know that as Muslims, we worship Allah alone. All of our worship is to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, and we don't worship his signs and his creations. And we ask Allah the Almighty to accept our good and forgive our evil. And I hope it's clear about Tawheed and Shirk. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.